Welcome to SG Climate Reviews. Today we have the Maxus G10. So what is so special about the Maxus G10? Well, it is big, very big in fact. And it's not because we're comparing it to the model car just now. This is bigger in every regard when you compare it to like the Toyota Alphard. In fact, it is so tall that you have to be a little bit careful when you drive to certain car parks because this is 1.98 meters tall.
The 9-seater Maxus G10 Executive MPV is priced just under $149,000. The 2-litre turbocharged engine produces 215 brake horsepower and 330 Nm of torque, mated to a 6-speed automatic transmission. For more details on the G10 or any other car, head on to sgcarmart.com to help you make the smart choice on your next car.
So, big Maxus, big boot? Okay, so this is the 9-seater, so you do have this row of seats at the back. But with the 7-seater, you don't have this. And you have up to 2,500 liters of boot space. 2,500! And I'm pretty sure this comes really close. You do have to fold the seats though, to get there. Fold the seats here. Fold it upwards. You have quite a reasonable space. So, let's see how it does in the anti-trolley ramp test. As you can see, it doesn't pass the length test. But, if you put it upwards, it passes in the never-before-seen anti-trolley height test. And let's see how it does with the luggage bag. Again, if you want to put it straight in, you can't, but you can put it sideways. And of course, you can put it up. Not too shabby this. And also, you can fit me inside, which is not too bad. There we go. So really, it's quite a bit of space. It's very tall. That's one good thing about the Maxus G10. All right. To the back seats. Power doors on both sides. Alright, so of course the front seat is set to my comfortable driving position and I am just under 1.8 meters tall. There is quite a bit of space here. There's a lot of knee room actually, headroom of course. I mean, we don't even have to talk about it because there is a lot of headroom. But wiggle room is a little bit tight, but still, this is a very nice and spacious space. We have two captain seats up here. It is really quite comfortable here. And of course, there are some amenities. You have air conditioning vents on all three rows at the back. And by the way, you might not have USB ports, for example, but you have a full-size 3-pin socket. You want to charge your laptop or something, you can. Not bad. Right, let's go to the next row. We have three rows in this car. Three rows! Right. Right, so I didn't adjust the seat in front and it is a little bit tight. But it is still quite comfortable. These seats are the same as the ones in front. They feel nice and snuggly. And of course, if you do want to stretch out, you can because you do have a flat floor and there's a lot of space for you to put your stuff. So you don't really feel very claustrophobic like some 7-seaters on the market today. Well, this is of course a 9-seater. And speaking of the 7-seater, of course, I do remember that Maxus G10 did have USB ports over here. But for some reason, the 9-seater, we don't have them. But of course, you still have other amenities like this. Aircon vents over here. Let's go to the front.
final row, the last row, alright. Okay, you are supposed to fit 3 people in the last row over here, and that makes the Maxus G10 a 9-seater. It is a little bit tight over here, but of course, if you adjust the seats a little bit, you can have a bit more space for adults at the back. To be honest, this is actually not too bad. It's a bit tight, yes, but if I need to do a long trip, I think I can do quite well in the last row, to be honest. And of course, you still have aircon vents all the way to the back. 9 seats, Maxus G10. All right, let's go to the front seat. Right, so getting in and out of the Maxus G10 does take a little bit of effort because the floor is really quite high. So when you get in, it's good to grab the handlebar over here and swing yourself in, and all will be fine. But when you're in, the seats are really quite comfortable. It's just the same seats like the ones in the rear. Well, elsewhere, of course, when you look at the interior, it looks quite good from afar. But of course, if you come closer, you can feel a lot of hard plastics everywhere. But although it might feel a bit utilitarian, this interior feels like it will last for a very long time. Of course, whether it does, we will have to see in the next few years. Well, I think this is really a nice space. But there are some quirks of the Maxus G10. For example, the interior light over here, the switch doesn't really indicate which one is on or off. You just have a very weird cross across the interior lamp icon over here, which is a bit angled in a strange way. So if you actually have it on and you turn it off, you don't really know until the light fades away. And if you unlock the doors using the panel over here and you press too many times, you end up opening the rear boot, which is a little bit strange because you do have a dedicated button to open the boot over here. Let me just close the boot again. There we go. So of course, all these quirks really won't matter if you are actually an owner of the car. You just learn that it has a little bit of issues and then you just learn to live with it. But elsewhere, of course, this interior is quite a usable one. You have a lot of storage space, big cubby hole over here. You have cup holders up front, a pocket over here. And if you drink so much water, you need more cup holders. You have some over here. You have one small one over here. And what I really like, because I have a habit of taking out my cash card whenever I park the car, is that this car has 2 cubby holes. So you can put small items here and big items at the bottom. I think that's quite smart. It makes a lot of use of the very big door card over here. Well, of course, let's talk about infotainment. Well, this infotainment looks like an Android head unit, but the good thing is that it does come with Apple CarPlay. So, good thing is that you can load up all your maps, your music, if you want to. I think it's a very good job that Maxus included this in the car. There we go, Apple CarPlay. So, let's find out how the Maxus G10 does on the road. Now, the first thing that you realize when you're driving the Maxus G10 is how much of a view it offers you of the road ahead. I mean, these windows are really nice and big. The mirrors are too. And you're sitting quite high off the ground, I feel. So this is quite useful because the Maxus G10 is quite big. So having a car that is easy to see out of means that you can navigate through small areas really very well. You do have a 360 camera that you can activate while you're on the move in case you ever need it. It is not too bad. And also, it's quite comfortable on the road, to be honest. These seats are nice and supple, so the car rides quite well. But there's a bit of road noise which comes into the cabin. I think it's partly because of the tires. And also, the seats sort of rattle a little bit, yeah. Partly because, I mean, you have 9 seats at the back. So, you know, well, it does the job, really. It really does the job. So, let's talk a little bit about power. Well, this comes with a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine. It makes 215 brake horsepower and 330 newton meters of torque. It is paired to this 6-speed torque converter automatic. And to be honest, it is a bit agricultural at times. It is a little bit loud, but it has quite cool noises. It makes a lot of turbo whistling noises when you put your foot down. And it is quite torquey also, so it's great because after all, you're moving this big HDB flat around. So I think you definitely need the power. It is not incredibly quick, but it gets you around. It's quite a bit of torque. There we go. Woo woo, the turbo whish, all the turbo whistles. Very nice. Shoo 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 shoo. It's like an old turbo car really. It's quite nice. Old school turbos this. So, safety features, well, you do have a 360 view camera, which is useful for parking. You can activate it for seconds at a time while driving if you really need to. It can be useful. In fact, it is very useful. After all, this car is very big. But it doesn't come with blind spot monitoring. I do know the 7-seater comes with blind spot monitoring. So, but it doesn't really matter because these wing mirrors are really, really big. They have, you can see. You can see Indonesia from here. You can see KL from here, man. That's how big the wing mirrors are. Well, so yeah, it's really not bad. It does the job. You want to bring 9 people around or 7 people, this will do it very well. Is it a will buy, won't buy, or go try the Maxus G10? Well, for me, it is a go try. This Maxus G10 has one very good quality, which is space. It is big and it carries people. That's the main thing about the Maxus, about the Maxus G10. It carries people well. You can fit 9 people in here or 7 people if you want to. And when you talk about full-size MPVs or MPVs in general, not many MPVs are really MPVs, I feel. Usually the last row can only fit kids at best. And well, if you consider like the Toyota Alphard, that is a very good 7-seater or 8-seater or whatever configuration you want to MPV. But that's also very expensive, and to be honest, that's more of a luxury MPV. Most people are using it for chauffeur services and stuff, VIP ferrying services. This Maxus then isn't that luxurious, let's be honest. It is a people mover. And when it comes to people moving, this, I feel, does it the best. So, at about $140,000, it's almost $100,000 cheaper than even the Alphard. The Alphard does it well, this one does it well too. Carrying people is your thing? Well, get into the Maxus. Maximize your space. Maxus. Good stuff. So we've come to the end of our review of the Maxus G10. What do you guys think? Is the Maxus G10 your thing or any other MPV that you guys prefer that can fit more than 7 people? Well, let us know in the comment box down below. And of course, if you want to see more reviews from us, don't forget to like and subscribe to SG Carmine. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.